These are two last-minute DIYs that I'm bringing to you today, but I say better late than never. Hey everybody, welcome back to Kelly Barlow Creations. If you're new to my channel and you're stopping by for the first time, thank you for stopping by. Welcome to my channel. Stick around a while by clicking that red button for more crafting on a budget, more everything on a budget videos to come. And if you click it again when the bell appears, YouTube should notify you every time I upload a new video, depending on the option that you choose in the drop-down menu of the bell. If you're interested in following me on social media, you can find those links, you guessed it, in the description box below. What have I got going on for you for today? Today is February 28th, Monday, February 28th. I was just in Dollar Tree and I saw them restocking St. Patrick's Day decor. Now, St. Patrick's Day is only a couple weeks away. I know this. And there are a couple of DIY series that I typically bring to you, one being the slide plaque and two being a garden banner. Those are two DIY series that I try to bring you for every season and holiday. And those series are far from being over, but this year I was really just struggling with inspiration for St. Patrick's Day. Dollar Tree hasn't been stocking a lot of the items for it, and the managers told me it was because they were having trouble getting product in. And so today when I was in and I saw them stocking it, some inspiration came to me. I found a couple of items that I could totally use to make the slide plaque and a garden banner. So that is just what I'm bringing to you today. This is two DIYs in one because like I said, it's better late than never. That must be Dollar Tree's motto as well. So I'm gonna quit my gabbing. Let's jump into it and let me show you what I have in mind for you for today for the slide plaque and a garden banner. These are quick, easy, and did I say budget friendly? That's what we do here. Let's get to it. Who is today's KB Creations Crafter of the Day? You'll want to stick around to the end of the video to see if it's your creation that's being featured in today's video. For today's garden banner, I'll be using this black felt roll. This is by Crafter Square. You can find this at Dollar Tree. This is a decent size roll. You're getting 11¾ inches by 48 inches. That's pretty long. This isn't the best quality felt, I'd say. It's on the thinner side, so to thicken it up, I fold it over and make it a double layer. To measure how long or how big I need my banner to be, I'm gonna go ahead and place these wood slats that I will be using and this galvanized sign. And so once I know about how long it will be, I can double fold it. Then I will take the top and fold it down because we need to make a pocket for our banner. And so in doing that, this is going to be the backside of the banner. Yeah, the backside. Did I say that? Yeah, it's gonna be the backside. Almost lost my train of thought there. I'm using hot glue for my garden banner. If you wanna sew it, I say sew it. Am I worried about the glue holding up to the elements? In my area, I'm not. It's only March, so it's not super hot out, so I don't have to worry about it. That's the pocket there, see? Yep, that's the pocket that the hanger's gonna go through. I'm gonna fold that part down and hot glue it. And like I was saying, this is a high temperature glue gun, so the temperatures would have to reach a pretty high temperature to soften up this glue. The pocket here up at the top, we've got this open side on both sides. I'm gonna go ahead and glue that shut, or you're gonna sew it shut, but you don't wanna sew shut the pocket, because then how are we gonna hang it? I went digging into my fabric stash and pulled out this green plaid fabric that I had, folded in the edges and ironed them, cut those corners nice and neat, and I used hot glue to hold those edges down. I cut this fabric just a bit smaller than the felt itself, so the felt will actually be framing out the fabric. And again, I'm gonna use some hot glue to adhere this down to the felt. I think some thick stitching from a sewing machine would be really nice and add some character to this. But because I like to make these garden banners no sew for those who don't sew, I'm good with it. I think it's gonna look great nonetheless. Earlier, I told you that I'd be using these wood planks by Crafter Square.
You're gonna need four of them, and to these wood planks, I'm gonna give them a good base coat of some white chalk paint. That's Waverly's chalk paint. You can buy it online now. I love it. It comes in packs of three. I can't help it. I'm totally gonna add stitching to this too because I feel like it adds so much to the piece. It really finishes it off. I decided to go with a bit of a thicker stitch because these are a bigger plaque and I really wanted the stitching to stand out a bit more. I was pretty excited to see that Dollar Tree restocked these foam shamrocks the other day. To these, I'm not leaving them glitter. I will be painting them using a combination of Hello Hobbies Cafe Brown and Waverly's Fern to really rustic up that green a bit. And this is the green I came up with. And of course, to this shamrock, I'm gonna add some white stitching. This galvanized welcome sign, I think, will be the perfect addition to this garden banner. And to this welcome sign, we can't leave it silver. Oh no, no, it's St. Patrick's Day. So I'll be adding some of this metallic gold paint by CraftSmart. Now, I must not have pressed record. I did not use a paintbrush for this. I used one of Dollar Tree's yellow sponge dabbers, and it really applied a nice thick coat of this metallic paint. And we didn't have those pesky brush lines in this. And so if you just use a sponge dabber and dab on that gold, if this is the gold you're using, you're gonna get a nice thick coat, and it only took two coats of the gold to get full coverage. And of course, I'm adding some black stitching to this. Yes, not predictable at all, right? Right. This here would be the top of my garden banner, where the pocket is, or the sleeve to put the garden banner hanger rod. Now I'm gonna go ahead and place my wood blocks. My wood blocks? Did I just say blocks? Oh my goodness, my wood planks. My word, again, I've had a couple cups of coffee already. I'm gonna place these and get them placed before I go in with the hot glue and actually permanently adhere them onto my banner. And up here at the top is going to be my galvanized gold welcome word. Who knew I loved gold so much? I feel like I'm kind of branching out. Change is good, right? Stranger things have happened. So now that I've got everything placed, I'm feeling like it's safe to go ahead and just pound everything with a ton of hot glue and put it into its rightful place, its permanent place. What do I have in mind for the center of these white planks? Well, I thought the word home with the O being a shamrock would be fun for this garden banner. Now, I've cut these out using my Cricut. We've got the die cut out of the letters. Now we've got a stencil here that's gonna be available in Linda's Etsy store too. So if you wanna paint it on using the stencil, you can do that. The die cut and the stencil are a bundle for the bargain price of $3 in her Etsy store with free shipping. That is such a great buy because stencils are reusable. You can find the link to Linda's Etsy store, guess where? In the description box below. If you're gonna use the stencil for your garden banner, I suggest using one of Dollar Tree's yellow sponge dabbers. That is the easiest way to apply paint when using a stencil so you don't get the bleedage. Michaels has this CraftSmart pack of stencils. It comes in several different fonts. It's about $5.99 a pack, and if you use a coupon, you're gonna get a discount. It's a great alternative to the Cricut if you don't have a Cricut or just using regular embellishments. Since I've got the cardstock letters because they come as a bundle with the stencil, I'm gonna use the letters and just use some hot glue to apply them. Now, because these are paper and they are gonna be outside, I am going to seal these planks. The varnish that I'm using today is this varnish by Waverly. This is a matte, durable sealant varnish that is good for indoor and outdoor use, and it's non-yellowing. Perfect. We all know that varnish yellows sometimes, that pesky varnish. So that's what I'm gonna use because I use the cardstock letters. I decided I really didn't wanna use the cardstock shamrock. I forgot that I had painted the foam shamrock. And I did that because I wanted to add a green shamrock, not a black one. If you can't get your hands on the foam shamrocks, well, the cardstock letters come with one. So you can use that. But since I've got the green foam one, I'm just gonna take that pesky black one off and replace it with this cute green one, adding just a touch more green to this garden banner, St. Patrick's Day garden banner. Even though these are a cardstock letter, I just felt like they needed some stitching, and because it's black lettering that I'm using, I didn't want to go with white. I thought it was a good excuse to add more gold. I'm loving this metallic gold. Ah, yes. I am so glad I decided to do this because I am loving this St. Patrick's Day garden banner. We're not done yet. We still have the slide plaque DIY using one of these shamrock plaques where the center is detachable. Love that. Since it can be detachable, we're gonna do away with this green satin ribbon. It's not twine. I went digging around looking for some green burlap. This is a scrap piece because I keep my scraps. Loving this green. It's gonna be perfect for this smaller shamrock. Now, because you can kind of see through the burlap and I don't want to see the brown, I'm going to take that cool rustic green that I made and just give this one simple base coat of that green. So when we put the burlap on, you won't see through it. But before we put that burlap on, we need to give this plaque a nice healthy coat of some Mod Podge. And when I say healthy, you want it nice and thick because that burlap is really going to absorb the Mod Podge, and it's a heavier weight fabric. Yeah, burlap is a fabric. Once we get that burlap on top of that Mod Podge, we're gonna go in with a second coat of Mod Podge over the top of the burlap to really adhere it onto this clover. And in turn, it's going to stiffen up the burlap so when we cut it, it won't fray. To this outside shamrock, I'm gonna give that a good coat of Mod Podge because guess what I'm covering it with? Yes, more burlap. Only the burlap I'm using is a brown burlap, and since we're using the backside, there was no need for a base coat of paint. I let this set overnight. You can see it's nice and dry. Using a straight edge razor with a safety holder on it, that's what I'm gonna call this. I'm gonna use the plaque as a guide to cut off the excess burlap. It is best to use a nice, fresh, sharp blade so you can get a nice, good, clean cut. I am. I'm gonna add stitching to the burlap. I have to because it just looks too plain. Again, this is your DIY. I'm just bringing to you the idea. So you take what you like, you leave what you don't, and you get creative and make it your own. So if stitching isn't for you, distress it, darken up those edges. I've known to do that a time or two. Just lately, I've been into this stitching, and so I'm just gonna go with it. If you wanna add rhinestones to the edges of it because you like more of that bling added to it, I say do it. It's your DIY. Do it to suit your decor. The outside, because it was a brown burlap or a beige tan burlap, did get some green stitching. Would you look at how cute this is? Oh my goodness, who knew St. Patrick's Day could be so rustic and cute? I love burlap for St. Patrick's Day. It's perfect. Green burlap, where can you get it? At Hobby Lobby. It's actually pretty cheap. It's $1.99 a yard. I'm gonna use a thicker twine, and where that green ribbon once was, on the backside, I'm gonna add some twine, only I'm gonna add it to 4 points because I don't want the center of my plaque turning. If you want to make that center plaque reversible, you could totally DIY both sides and have it say something cute like I am Irish, luck of the Irish, if you wanted to. On one side, you could put blessed like I'm going to. You'll see that in a second. I'm getting a little ahead of myself. But if you wanted to make this a double-sided inside plaque, just add the one piece of twine there at the top. Again, because I am doing only one side for this, yes, I'm gonna put 4 pieces of twine. The bless that I'm using is this wood word that I wanna say I had in my stash from a fall and harvest pack that had 8 wood words in it. I really loved this. I thought that this would be the perfect addition to the center of the green plaque. It is broken, but that's okay. It's not gonna stop me from using it. I'll fix it, easy fix. Using the gold, you can see that I am dabbing that metallic gold on and how thick it's coming on. It's even giving it kind of a texture that I really kind of like. And so, yeah, I think that's the way to apply it. I wish I would have known this during my tiered tray. It would have saved me like 4 coats. To adhere this wood blessed onto the green burlap shamrock there, I'm just gonna use some of this wood glue by Crazy Glue. Aileen's would work too, just don't have any on hand. So this will work. And once I place it in the center there, nobody will be none the wiser that it was once broke. I'm loving it, I am. The rustic feel of this shamrock. It couldn't be more me. Here is a quick recap on how I DIY'd that stand for these plaques for those of you that are new to my channel. Alrighty, so getting started. Yep, today we're gonna be using these plaques that you can get year round at Dollar Tree. We've all seen these. You're gonna need 2 of them. These are the perfect size for today's DIY. And I'm also gonna be using these terrible beads. I'm going for shape here, not color. We can fix the color. The glue I'll be using today is this wood glue by Super Glue that you can find, guess where? In the tool section, not the craft section. I'm gonna go ahead and place a bead of glue along that outside edge of the plaque. Then I'm gonna place the beads right along that bead of glue I just placed. Once I've got all the beads in place and they're pretty well dry, I'm gonna go ahead and run a bead of glue along the top of all of these beads. A bead of glue along the top of the beads. Ah, I'm a dork, I know it. Then I'm gonna place the other plaque face down. That way we've got the back side of the plaque up so we don't have to worry about, yes, covering up the design on these plaques. It's just gonna be in the middle there. Nobody's gonna see it. You know how I am about these holes. So yes, I am going to take some of Dollar Tree spackling and fill them in, because why would we have holes if we don't need to have holes when we can use this here stuff, plug them up, and yeah, we've got a nice solid plaque without, yeah, holes in it. Quick trick, we all know that these pesky stickers are so hard to get off. They are a pain in the butt. Who likes taking them off? If you take a blow dryer or a heating tool, run it over the top of them and get them a bit warm, yes, they'll peel right up in one piece. I'm gonna place 2 rows of Jenga blocks down the center of this plaque, or this soon-to-be stand. When I place the Jenga blocks though, I'm gonna place my first row, and then when I place my second row, I'm gonna put just about 1/4 inch, maybe even less, of a gap between the 2 rows, because this is gonna be a plaque stand. So we only want the width between the 2 rows of Jenga blocks to be wide enough for a plaque, when a Dollar Tree's DIY wood plaques or their decorative plaques, to slide in there. For the feet of this stand, I'm gonna use these caps. This is an assortment that you can get at Walmart by Plaid. It comes with 8 of them, 2 different sizes, 4 of each size. I'm using the smaller ones for this stand. My stand is dry and it is looking good, right? This is such a fun series. You can find a playlist of this series in the description box below or on the end screen of this video. Who is today's KB Creations Crafter of the Day? It's going out to Audrey, who's bringing to us her recreation of the DIY Valentine's Day floating balloons that I brought to you all. I am so glad to see that somebody did them. Audrey, thank you so much for sharing your creation with us today. Kayla's uploading today. Professional baker now? Oh my word. If you are in need of a good laugh today, you need to head over to her channel to watch her try out Dollar Tree's Cupcake Froster. This is one that I did a couple weeks ago. Kayla is bound to put a hilarious twist on it. You can find the link to Kayla's video today, guess where? In the description box below.
These are 2 DIYs that I love bringing to you because they're interchangeable, and that really kind of has been the theme on my channel the last year and a half, is to bring you those decor pieces that you can put out and just interchange the pieces for the holidays and for the seasons, because I think that just makes decorating a lot easier. I hope you all enjoyed today's 2 Dollar Tree St. Patrick's Day DIYs. Please make sure to give this video a big thumbs up, and let's get this video to, you guessed it, 5,000 likes, because like I always say, each and every one of your thumbs up and those comments that you do leave down below, they really do help my channel to grow, and It helps YouTube to notice me just a bit more. Until next time, everybody, I hope you have a fantastic day. Happy crafting on a budget. Stay happy, stay safe, stay healthy, but most of all, stay positive, please, and bye for now, everybody.